Dissection is a procedure of cutting an animal or plant so as to study its internal structure, that is anatomy. On dissecting an animal, student is able to study the organs of that animal. Student can observe positions of various organs inside, can study details of those organs like which are the tissues present in the organ, function of that organ, etc. Also, comparison of that animal with others can be done so as to study similarities and differences among animals. Generally, preference is given to certain animals as their bodies provide a good overview of various organ systems. For example, earthworm and cockroach are dissected to study anatomy of lower animals that belong to non-chordates. On the other hand, frog and rat are the animals that have anatomy very much similar to humans. Hence, their dissection helps students understand anatomy very well and can relate it with the human body. Students, before studying anatomy of frog or rat, let's understand some basic concepts. In case of frog, rat, or any chordate animal, bones are present inside the body. In the bodies of frog or rat, backbone is present on dorsal side and other organ systems are on ventral side. Hence, these animals are dissected from ventral side while studying their anatomy. Dissection of frog. Frog is a chordate animal, that is an animal having bones inside the body. Also, it is an amphibian, that means it lives in water as well as on land. Now let's see the anatomy of frog with the help of a dissected animal. We will first see various organs of digestive system starting from mouth. The major organs are mouth, pharynx, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and cloaca. There are accessory glands, namely liver, pancreas, gallbladder. The digestive system digests food eaten by frog and then digested food is absorbed in blood. Now, after observing various organs, now I will tell you little more about each one of them. Mouth. It is an opening present in head region that is called anterior end. Inside mouth, there is a mouth cavity, tongue, teeth, just like humans. Pharynx and esophagus. Food from mouth cavity goes to pharynx and then into esophagus. Students, you can see esophagus as a tube joining mouth and stomach. Stomach. Now students, look at the left hand side of model. You will see a muscular bag like organ, that is stomach. Food eaten by frog is partly digested here. Small intestine. Stomach joins a coiled tube like organ, that is small intestine. Small intestine of frog is also coiled like human. Food is completely digested in small intestine. Now students, have a look at the glands one by one. Liver, pancreas and gallbladder. These three glands are connected with small intestine. Their enzymes play an important role in digestion. Large intestine and cloaca. Small intestine opens into large intestine. Undigested food is stored in large intestine and then it moves to cloaca. Cloaca is an opening to throw out undigested food out of body. So students, you must have realized that frog eats its food, then it is digested and undigested food is removed from the body. All these series of events are very much similar to us. But do you know one fact that frog does not drink water like us? That is through mouth. Water enters its body through skin. This was the account of digestive system. Now, I will tell you little about the heart of the frog and blood circulation. The circulatory system of frog includes heart, blood vessels, blood and lymphatic system. Where is heart of frog situated in the body? Heart is situated on the ventral side of liver in the middle of the body at the level of four limbs. Students, if we compare heart of frog with human heart, it is primitive. Heart of frog has three compartments or chambers internally and we have four. Heart pumps blood that transports water, food, oxygen to various body organs. Frog has closed circulation just like humans, means blood flows through blood vessels. Apart from this, frog has a pair of kidneys which form urine. Urine is stored in urinary bladder. Can you see yellow colored finger like structures called fat bodies? They are a source of stored energy for the animal. During hibernation, that is inactive time during winter, growth and reproduction does not happen. Now students, let's know little about brain of frog. Nervous system of frog is well developed. It is mainly located in the head region of frog. Nervous system of frog and that of man show many structural similarities. There is brain, spinal cord and nerves that form nervous system. Of course, human brain has more complex structure than frog. Brain of frog does many important functions like coordination, balance, response to environment, sense of smell, vision, etc. So students, I have told you about various body parts of frog. You must have realized that broadly most of these parts are present in our body, also doing more or less similar functions.